This is the video review for the Transformers Dark of the Moon Supreme Class Ultimate Optimus Prime. And this will be a two-parter. This time we are just covering the tractor, but I will show what the tractor hauling the trailer looks like. Quite big. Trailer goes off to the side now. The tractor itself is quite nice. It rolls very well. It's quite solid. Nothing really shifts under the pressure of holding it. And holds together quite well. It's sturdy. It looks pretty accurate and I like it. Rolls well. The only problem I have with it is that it's a little bit wide. And that's for the combined mode with the trailer. And even as it is, the chest is still a little bit not wide enough. So this figure, I think, was probably sort of a balancing game for the designers. Because on one hand, they had to give it big beefy arms in combined mode. On the other hand, they still had to give this thing a serviceable robot mode. And considering how all four modes work, there's this guy, the trailer, this guy in robot mode, and this guy combined with the trailer, how well everything, for the most part, works. Actually, everything works. I do think they did a stellar job, and I'm willing to forgive the faults that this thing has for the combined mode, and I'll even say I like this thing, even its robot mode, just this tractor here, a lot more than the actual combined mode. There's just something charming about this tractor, even though the robot mode is a little bit odd. So to transform it, you'll pop up these. They unpeg from little holes here and pull them out like this. Bring them up, fold them in, and peg them in here. Rotate these down and around, and they will tab in here. Then you will take the legs. You will pop them free of the tabs in here, and you will rotate them down. Pop free out so they untab from here and rotate down. And then what you will do is you will keep this as straight as possible so that these tabs here won't bump into anything. And then you will turn it, you'll push it up and turn it, and that will lock it into place without causing much plastic scrape. Next, what we'll do is we'll take these sides here, pull them up. Take this bottom panel, pull it up, and detach it. Pull these arms out, which will allow us to pull this up. Don't fold it up just yet. And then, coming back to the front, we can split the arms, which will cause the head to spring up. Rotate this around so it's out of the way. And this comes out on a hinge, so hinge it down and then rotate it over and above. And it's a little bit tricky to do, but you will tab these tabs into those slots in there. And then this will come in flat over there. Rotate the arms around, Take these shoulder panels and lay them flat. Then this will tab into the back and we can put that flat. Open up these panels here and slide out the hands. And this is Optimus Prime in robot mode. It's quite big, despite the arms, fairly well proportioned, like take away the arms, pretty well proportioned. The only problem is that these sort of muscle bits that are for Dark of the Moon have been added to the Optimus Prime design. These look like abdomen pieces, but they come in right under the pecs, as opposed to being right where the abdomen is. So this is just a blank spot, and it looks like that's all his chest is supposed to be, and then right here should be pelvis. So, because these are up here rather than down here, this does look a little bit too long. If this were down here, and they went with the movie 1 and 2 designs, just having red slats that come down here, I think this would have looked a lot better. And, well, the obvious faults are obvious, like the wheel well arms. But considering what these have to do in the combined mode, and that they're not that big of a deal, they're kibble, but they don't get in the way of what's otherwise a very fun toy, I don't mind it. And really, that's this guy's strong suit. He doesn't look as good as the other Primes, but he's very fun. He has a solid alt mode, a fun, simple and easy transformation, and a solid robot mode. It does everything you could want it to do, except look exactly right, I suppose. It's got quite a bit of articulation, and overall, just a very good toy. In this mode, for articulation, his head looks left and right. Shoulders go back, forth, and out. He has a bicep swivel, and the elbows only go up from the front, about that far from the side, 90 degrees, and then his hands can go in. His legs go back, forward, out, rotate above the knee, and a little bit more than 90 degrees on the knee, and then these can rotate down. So the only annoying things are that the hands slide in from time to time, and these panels. Otherwise, it's just overall a fun toy with some slightly odd proportions. And I like him quite a bit. Those are my thoughts. Thank you for watching.